the red subscribe button right under the video and also the bell icon to get notification on any of our latest updates on our videos.
In our previous tutorial, we talked about linear measurement and see that there are some errors that are to be corrected. In order to have a high accuracy measurement, so in this question, in this tutorial, we have a question here that says a line was measured with a steel tape, which was exactly 30 meter. So the length of the steel tape, our data is 30 meter at 18 degrees centigrade. So our standard temperature of the tape is 18 degrees centigrade and a pool. Therefore, our standard pool of the tape is given as 50 Newton, and the measured length, so measured length, the LM, was 459.242 meter. Stop. Temperature during measurement. So temperature during measurement TM is equal to 28 degrees centigrade, and the pool applied, or applied pool, our pool during measurement is equal to 100 Newton. The tape was uniformly supported during the measurement. So the tape was uniformly supported during the measurement. Find the true length. We have to find the true length. Let's see LT or LE, the actual length of the line of the cross section in L area of the tape of the line. If the cross section area, sorry, is if not up. So the cross section area of the tape A is given as 0.02 centimeter squared, and the coefficient of linear expansion is given as 0.00001117 per degree centigrade. Lastly, our modulus of elasticity, Young modulus, is given as 21 × 10⁻⁶ Newton per centimeter squared. Our Young modulus is 21 × 10⁻⁶ Newton per squared centimeter. So from the question here, they say that the tape was uniformly supported during the measurement. Since it is supported, uniformly supported, you know that there must be since it is uniformly supported, there will not be any sag correction. So our sag correction will be equal to zero. And there's a pull during the measurement given as 100 Newton. So therefore, we have to find our pull correction, and also there's a variation of temperature from the standard temperature 18 degrees centigrade to 28 degrees centigrade during measurement. So we also have to find our temperature correction. We have to find them for us to determine the actual length of the line. So as we discussed in our previous tutorial, we know that this pull correction is given as pull during measurement minus standard pull of the tape over area times our modulus of elasticity, yeah, times the length of the tape. The parameters are given from the question. So we can just substitute into this formula. We have our pull loom measurement as 100 Newton minus standard pull of the tape is 50 times our area given is 0.02. If we are to combine convert this area to square meter have to multiply by 10 power minus 2. I'm sorry, here we have length, not area. The given length is 30 meters. I'm sorry. Here our area is 0.02 times 10 power minus 4. Now in squared meter, yeah, they are all in Newton. Times our modulus of elasticity is given as 21 times 10 power 6. Newton over 10 power minus 4 in squared meter. We have to combine this squared centimeter into squared meter. Therefore, our pole position is equal to 50 Newton times 300 meter. This 10 power minus 4 come to the upside, up will come up. We have times 10 power minus 4. So squared meter all over here we have 0.02 times 10 power minus 4 squared meter times 21 times 10 power 6 Newton. So we just cancel this. This Newton here cancel this one. We are left with 50 times 300 meter all over 0.02 times 21 times 10 power 6. So by putting all the values in our calculator, our pole correction will be 0.00357 meters. Second one, we have our temperature correction, which is given as alpha coefficient of linear expansion times into major temperature degree measurement minus our standard temperature times L. Our coefficient of linear expansion is given as 0.000117, and our temperature degree measurement is 28 degrees centigrade minus standard temperature of the tape 18 times the length of the tape is called 30. Therefore, our temperature correction is 0.00351. Now, our total correction will be the combination of the two. It's equal to 0.00571 plus 0.00351, which will give us 0.007081. So from here our true length of the tape will be the given length of the tape 30 plus our correction 0.007081, which is equal to 30.00781. So in order to find the true length of the line, we have to form a relationship by saying the given length of the tape all over the true length of the tape equals the given length of the line over the true length of the line. Therefore, here we have 30 over our true length. We calculated it as 30.00781 because the given length is 459. The given length of the line 459.242 over our true length. Let's say x. So this implies that x is equal to 459.242 times 30 point, so we have 30.00 serving at 1 all over 30. Therefore, the two lengths of the line is called 459.35 meters instead of 459.242. The two length of line will be 459.350 meters. Thank you for watching. If you have any query, feel free to write it in the comment section provided. Thank you.